Hi guys, welcome back to another video. You join me again back at home. This is part three, the second part, which was all about creating the pinouts to make a plug and play adapter to go from the standard OEM ECU to an aftermarket ECU. In my case, it's an EMU black, but any ECU, the process is the same. So in this video, I'm gonna be taking the information I gathered from the last video and creating the plug and play adapter itself. So I'll jump straight in. Okay, so what you can see here is the gutted out ECU. So it's just had the circuit board removed and only the pins remain. So what I'm doing is just going through the process of soldering a wire to each of the pins that I need. If you can see in the background there, you can see my computer screen. So that's just me, again, utilizing that pinout information so I can work out what wires go where, what gauge wire, where those wires go in terms of the connectors on the EMU black, and also just to enable me to create some labels for each wire. So again, it's quite a simple process, but it's a bit laborious because obviously there's quite a few wires, but that's kind of it. In terms of tools required to do the job, soldering iron, clearly, solder, set of crimpers, set of wire strippers, the ECU, which has been gutted, a bunch of wires, some masking tape so you can make some labels, and then obviously the connector block for the aftermarket ECU. So obviously get the wires to the length you require, use the wire strippers on each end, and then start soldering. So you saw in the last clip, I was just soldering literally the wires onto the pins. Once I'd done that, I just obviously checked and triple checked to make sure everything was in the right place. And then I use some heat wrap to insulate all the connections. And then on all the spare pins which aren't being used, I just use these little yellow ones just to cover the pins, again, just to insulate and protect any of the wires from touching. And as I mentioned before, drilled a couple of holes and put some grommets in the back of the ECU housing. And then obviously the wires just come out the back. Then you get to the other ends. And what you literally have to do is crimp the connectors onto the wires which come with the EMU black. There are two different types. One's a slightly bigger one than the other. And again, in my wiring diagram, let's see if I can bring it up. I'm not sure how clean that will come out on screen, but I also marked in purple any connector which has the larger size connector. So anything which isn't purple has a smaller style connector, anything in purple has the larger style. So in this case, this is the smaller style. So again, just crimp that on and then labeled it. This one is WBOVS, so that's part of the wideband sensor. Let's see if I can find a larger one. This is a larger one. So this is a larger type pin. Again, not sure how well it focuses. And these are sensor ground for knock and sensor ground for crank. So again, lots of crimping, lots of labeling. But again, once this is done, then I'm confident that I can put this in the car, wire it through the bulkhead, and then what I'm left with in the glove box will be a bunch of wires with a bunch of labels. Now, obviously, you've got to trust that these labels are correct, because then I'll use that information to put the connectors into the housing, and then it's done. Right, that's it for this video. Short and sweet on this one. To be honest with you, there's not a lot to it. All you're basically doing is soldering and insulating one end and crimping and labeling the other end. It's kind of as simple as that. So you use the information you've created in your custom pinout, and that information tells you your from and to when you're actually creating the harness, and ultimately that's it. On the next video, I'll be going into how to then install it into the vehicle to try and make it as accessible and easy as possible. But ultimately, that should be quite a simple video as well. As always, thanks for watching. If you've liked it, feel free to give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, hit subscribe, and I'll catch you for the next one. Cheers, bye.